where it is and all that. But it starts helping me. It tells me which way to go. Where is the gate that I need to go to? Where is the check-in counter that I need to go to? I've been in so many airports, and often I'm lost. Where is the United counter? And it turns out the driver left me at the wrong one. Imagine you're walking around and you start talking to your device or your watch or your glass or something like that, and you say, where's the power outlets in this place? I always want to know where the power outlets, don't you? And where's the free Wi-Fi, if there is any in this airport? Some airports are not so progressive as SFO is in giving us free Wi-Fi. But often there is free Wi-Fi somewhere on the airport grounds, usually near the luxury terminals. So if you know where those are, you get free Wi-Fi, right? And there's often a power outlet right outside somewhere, but you have to look around a little bit for that. And then you start thinking about, well, can I have a sushi dinner made for me to take on the plane? Well, today I often pass by my sushi restaurant in SFO Airport, and there's a line there, and I don't have time. I wish I would have been able to order it through something like Topingo before I get there and have it just waiting at the counter, and I just go grab it and take it right to my gate. We can reduce pain in airports for a lot of people. We can tell people where the defibrillator machines are. I mean, if somebody has a heart attack in front of you, I sort of know what to do, but I don't know where a defibrillator is. And there are several at SFO. So could I talk to this airport assistant and say, where's the defibrillator and where's help for this person? We can improve airports in a lot of ways, and that's what I'm really excited to see what you guys come up with and how you're going to improve our lives as we travel from here to there. And thanks, Reg, for inviting me to moderate today. We're going to keep it going. Let me introduce Reg and have him come back up on stage, because then he's going to introduce our first speaker from the local government, who is already starting to work on some of these things, right? Yeah. So thank you very much.